Okay, so if you guys make a mistake like I did right here, you just turn around and do the rest of it, like this part that I undo yesterday. So you continue, and right here we're going to put the line of clear. Just like this. Very simple. Like that. We're going to make this line right here. We did the one on the bottom. Now we're going to do the one on the top. So, dark blue. Clear. Dark blue. We need a clear one to make this turn. So, I'm going to cut this one out. So, stay out of the way. Cut these ends like that. So you don't get them in your way, just like that. Clear. Dark blue. Clear. Turn around. Now we are right here. The next one is light blue. Clear. I'm going to use something in this finger, and hopefully I can, hopefully I know how to work with this, because I need to have something in here so I can pull, you know, if I push the needle in it somehow like this, they didn't get into my finger. I do not even know the name of it. See, put it like this. I'm not used to, so I cannot do that. But when you do this kind of sewing, if you try to push the needle like this, the needle is kind of sharp right here, so it get through your skin. It's really, really painful. That's why I try to learn how to use this, but it's not easy. So I'm gonna try to use in this finger, maybe that way it helps. Anyway, clear. Light blue. Light blue. Clear. Dark blue. Clear. Light blue. Light blue. Clear. Dark blue. Clear. Light blue. Light blue. Clear. Anyway, I have to get used to it. I cannot get used to this. It's kind of too tight to my finger. And I'm not used to, so I cannot use that properly. So, I'm sorry for that. But that's what you need to use to push the needle. When you push it, do it this way. If you do it this way, you're going to get poke, and we do not want that. It's really, really painful, so try not to do that. Light blue. right there is going to be the last one of clear. So we're done with the line, like that. Now we have this, exactly like this one over here. If you wanna continue like that, go ahead and do it. I'm going to show you guys two different options so you decide which way you like it. You can do this part like that, in each one, in this side, and then this side, just like this, if you like it. If not, you do it like this one, all over, okay? This side and this side, that's up to you. I'm gonna show you different patterns, and I'm showing you how to make it, so all you need to choose the pattern that you like it, that's all. So from now on, it's gonna be light blue until we got 5 turns right here of blue in this side right here. So it's gonna be like that. It's light blue. 3 more turns. Then we're going to be done with this part, and we're going to make the other little arrow that I was talking about, with one line of clear, or if you can put 2 lines of clear if it's the how you like it. I leave that up to you guys. You guys have to go back into the video that I'm going to show you guys. You guys know that I make a mistake when I was making this one right here, and I didn't put this one, this clear line, so I have to return and fix it, because I decide that I like to show you guys this way. But like I said, if you guys prefer the other one, then go ahead and use it. Whichever you guys like it better. In this case, I'm showing you however I like it. You know, like you guys know, this pattern to me is like from here all the way up to here, and from there you can continue making it, because you can go back and count right here, because that's what is going to be next, and then count this one and then do it ahead, and then, you know, on and on until finish whatever is that you're making. In this case, it's a bracelet. So to me, that's the pattern right here, from here all the way up to here, up to the last one of the clear one right here, because I can actually go back and count what's gonna be next right here. It depends how long that you need it, you know, if you like it close, close, if you like it open, open, that is up to you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you like to use size 8, you can use size 8. If not, you can use 11 or even 15 if you like it really, really tiny. That's up to you. So, just turn like that. Then we return this way. One more turn of light blue. Alright, so let's see what is it gonna be next. We made this one, it's this one over here. We are over here, so we're going to make the line of clear. So right here is going to be clear. Light blue. Clear. I'm sorry for you guys. Hear some noises, people walking outside. The office and they're making noises, so I'm sorry for that. Let's see. Right here, we make the turn. Like so. Clear. Light blue. Clear. Okay, so right here. There, right here. Now it's going to be dark blue. Clear. Light blue. Clear, dark blue, dark blue, clear, light blue, clear. clear. Dark blue. Dark blue. Clear. Light blue. Clear. Dark blue. We are almost there, so dark blue, clear, dark blue, looks very nice, isn't it? I love it. Look at that. Light blue. Dark blue. Clear. Right here. We close this part right here. We continue with the dark blue. Light blue. Light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. lifelong. The ends of the bracelet, that depends after you. If you want to end right here, you end right here. If you want to end in the middle of the light blue, you end up right there. That's up to you. So we have to figure it out that because it's the first time I made this one. And obviously I have no idea what am I doing. So sorry for that. Light blue. Light blue right here. It's just enough space to close it. So that is what I'm going to do. I'm going to move from here all the way up to here. I'm going up like that. Then I'm going one down this way. Like this. From here, go down here. About in the middle. Not exactly right in the middle, but kind of. We're going to put the button right there. Even if you want to use a metal closer, or just a single, you know, plastic button like that, it's beautiful, you see? So I'm gonna put it right there. I'm here, I need to be about this way. So I'm going down one like this. Get the button into it. It's going to be right there. So go down and then go up. Obviously on the other side is going to look kind of ugly, but we're going to fix that out later. But the first one have to be staying like that. Let me see, maybe I can turn around the other one. What is the other one? There, like that. So go down again like this. Make sure I didn't hug the thread. We do not want that. Just like that, kind of in the middle, not really in the middle, but kind of. This, see? So go on up and down until you get it straight where you like it. Right in the middle. Just like that. So go back down here. It's not that much a mess actually. So pass the needle for a couple of CVs like that. Like that. That way you reinforce it. Strong. This is strong enough. So continue passing the needle for a couple more CVs. Like that. Then go back where you come out. Like this. And see if you can go up again. Let's see if I can't get into the hole there like that. He's tried to put it in the middle. Doesn't have to be right on the middle, but kind of middle. Kind of in the middle. Just like that. And from here, pass the needle again for a couple of CBs down. The CBs are very shine, so it's not easy to get to them. Just like that. See? It's kind of strong enough. So from there you go up like this, down, up and down, up and down, until you get your button really, really secure. All right, go down like that. All right, let's say this way are going down. Let's see if I can one more time going in there. Try not to pass the thread like across the CBs. It's not that easy, but you can try not to do that. Let's see. Well, I guess that's it. Cannot go up again. Let's see. No, it's getting too tight. All right, so from here, go down like this, one at a time. Like that, or as many as you can, and that's it. Pull it tight, and there you have it. That's how you close this part right here with the button. Now right here, obviously you guys make knots right here. Your button is tight anyway, so if you need to make knots, make knots. If not, you just leave it like that. I'm gonna cut this off because I'm gonna show you how to make the loop. I'm gonna use size 11 CBs. The same color is the button, but not really, kinda. Let's see how many we're gonna need. Just like that. All right, grab your tail. Obviously you guys make knots and everything before you get over there. Me, I'm going to undo this pattern. I'm just showing you how to close this bracelet, but I do not going to keep it like that. That is the reason I didn't finish like properly, because I'm gonna get rid of it so I can make other videos. That's my goal, so that's what I'm going to do. See, right here, we done the churn, right? So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to go in below it like that, three, two. One more right here. So you need to go up like that, turn around, and then right here I'm going to put the CBs, then I'm going to try to make the loop. So hopefully it come out right. It's so hard to put this very tiny CBs into the needle. We're gonna put as many as we need it to. So, let's see. I know it's taking forever, but that's how it is. I do not going to count these CBs because that depends on the button. However bigger you guys use it, depends on that, that as many CBs that you're gonna need, all right? So it's going to be kind of like that. I didn't have CBs size 11 exactly this color blue. It's kind of a little bit off blue and stuff, but still, you know, it is blue. You guys do not pay attention in that because you guys gonna choose different colors anyway. Me, I'm just trying to give you guys an idea how to make a loop so they can close you guys' bracelet, and that's it. That's all it is. So let's see. Put it like that. Put the finger right here and try to see if it's going to go into this. See if you can close your bracelet like that. Let's see. See if you go like that. You're going to need a couple more. Because I have to be able to go around it very loose, now tight. Let's see. Now, now it's perfect. So you're going to need this many. If you guys like to count them, so. We're gonna put the needle exactly at this point. I leave 1, 2, 3, so I count 1, 2, 3, and then I'm gonna put it right here. Like that. And now, I cannot pass the needle again because like you guys see, my thread is very short. So all I'm going to do, I'm going to make sure it is tight, that's all. So I'm going up like this. This way. Careful where your tails. Just be careful with your tails because I like to get in your way. So go up like this. Now go down. Right. Just like that. All the way. Into this side right here, and then make sure it's right like that. Now we are going up this way. Just like that. Like you see, we are back into the place that we begin. Now we're gonna put the needle back to at least once after you put all the CBs on it. Pass the needle like that. Obviously, you guys gonna pass the needle as many times as you need it. Me, I'm gonna do it at least twice because my thread is almost gone, so I do not have time to put some more thread. You guys know how long it takes for me to thread a needle, almost 20 minutes. So I cannot wait to do that. I need to finish this video so I can make the others that I need to have done too. So that is the reason I'm just gonna pass the needle twice. But if you can do it more than twice, go ahead and do it, because you guys gonna have the time, first of all. So let's see, make sure you get each one of the CBs into your needle like that, just to make sure it's going to be secure. So from here, now you go down this way, like that, this way, now this way, so right here is so sure. What I'm going to do, I'm going to end up this one like that. I do not have enough to make knots. You guys leave enough thread right here so you can pass the needle for a couple of CBs up and down as many times as you need it to make sure your bracelet is going to be very secure. All right, me, I'm going to undo this so I do not need it. I'm just trying to give you guys an idea how to close your bracelet, right? So it's not exactly like in a half of it, but kind of. And there you have it. It looks like that. I'm gonna try to cut this thread right here. Hopefully it didn't come out, because I need to show you guys how it's going to look. Obviously, you guys thread the needle, pass the needle for the CBs that it needed to be, pass it in it, you know, in, out, in, out, or whatever, as many times you need to do that, and you need to cut all the ends after you make the knots. If you need it, you can put glue on it, if you need to do that too, all right? Right here, I'm gonna take off my stop B2. Hopefully it didn't fall apart before I finish the video. These are so big. These caddos are very big, but not that sharp. Sorry for that. All right, and there you have it. This is how I close my bracelet. So I hope you guys like it. Thank you. So you close your bracelet like that. It looks like that. Perfect, isn't it? I really, really love it the way it come out. Well, it looks like that. Then you can open it. Then it looks like that. Well, thank you very much for watching my videos. And would you please not forget to comment, rate, and subscribe to my channels. I really appreciate that so much. Let me try to put it on. Perfect. Looks like that. It's the same amount as over here, the same amount as on the other side. Like you guys see right there. It looks like that. I love it. I hope you guys like it as much as I do. Looks like that. It's loose enough, because the way it was before, with out this, it was really, really tight, and that is how you do not want it, your bracelet. You want it loose like that. Just playful. It looks like that.